Denise Fox with the Fox Team, and we just listed a beautiful 4-bedroom, 3.5-bath single family home. Thought this would be a great opportunity to kind of take you behind the scenes with us so you can see how we do what we do and take a house from listing to under contract.
Today, it is now 10 after 4 on Friday, only just over 24 hours later, and we already have, we're almost at full capacity, meaning we have 18 showings set up for today, 17 showings set up and booked for tomorrow, and 5 already booked for Sunday.
So we set a 12 o'clock deadline today to receive all our offers. And in the last 20 minutes, we've received 2 more offers, and one of our offers has upped their game with an escalation clause. So now I have a pile of all the offers, like, you know, it's just a big pile of mess now. But Rich has gone through and he's called all the lenders, and he's put this little blue piece of paper for me that has the offer summary details in it that I need to know. What I'm going to do now is take this pile of offers and I am going to go put our offer summary sheet on each one. So this offer summary sheet has all the terms that are in the contract that our seller is going to be concerned with. It's not always sale price that's the best. It's a combination of everything. So it's a combination of the sale price, the earnest money deposit, did they ask for seller help, did they add an escalation clause. So this has the offer price, that information, and the net to our seller. What was the settlement date? You know, is that gonna work with our client's schedule? What was the earnest money deposit? How much did they put down with the contract? What's their skin in the game right now? What type of financing are they using? And what contingencies did they include with the offer? Do they have a home inspection? Do they have a radon contingency? Do they have an appraisal? These are all contingencies that go into the contract. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take this big pile of mess that we've got going on and I'm gonna go put our offer summary sheet on it and bring some order to it. So when we present later today to our sellers, it'll be easy for them to decipher what we got going on. We ended up with 12 awesome offers. We've got our cover sheets neatly on each one. It was really clear. We had a top two, and as you saw, our clients selected the one that they wanted to work with the most. So the sad part about this day is now we have 11 people to call and give the bad news to that they were not the winner. Every one of those agents worked really hard. They had taken their time to put those offers together and, you know, did the best that they could for their people. So that part's not good, but it is part of the job.